Hi, this is Lynn from WisconsinGarden.com. And yes, it's still winter. In fact, today when I woke up, it was 11 degrees and now it's 9 degrees. And we have 30 to 40 mile per hour gusts. So I don't even want to think what the wind chill is today. And it's supposed to be, I think they said 25 to 30 below zero wind chill this evening.
Now, wait a minute. When we grew up here in Wisconsin, there was no such thing as wind chill.
I know.
And we'd be outside playing and having
fun.
We'd
be ice skating.
Well, yeah.
So we're not going to go outside today. We're going to see what we can do in the house getting ready for spring, and then take a really fun look at some of the plants that we have in the house that are blooming. So the first thing I wanted to talk about was banana peels. We were talking to one of the gardeners that we met, and she said she always plants her tomatoes with a banana peel. And we were thinking, well, how in the heck do you have enough bananas to plant your tomatoes unless you're only doing one or two? But then she said she freezes them and keeps them all winter in the freezer, which when they thaw out, they will be partly decomposed because freezing does that too. Fresh fruit. So in they go with the other one. And then in the spring, we're going to do a comparison between planting the way I usually plant and adding a banana. So these go in the freezer. You fill one bag up, start another bag. If you're in weather like this, you could just put them outside.
Now I have a question
yes.
for you. Why would you put a banana peel in the ground?
Because it's full of potassium. And tomatoes and vegetables like potassium.
Well, what part of a tomato plant likes potassium or even uses it?
The roots.
Okay, and so the stem?
Oh, I'm sure the whole plant likes
yeah.
it. But if you think back into your Native American studies when you were in grade school or wherever, at least when we were, they said that the Indians, the Native Americans, taught the pilgrims to put a fish, a dead fish, in each hole when they planted their food, their corn. And so they obviously knew what they were talking about, and sure enough, the corn did much better putting the fish in the hole. So this is putting the banana in the hole.
So you're not going to grow banana trees?
No, but thinking about it. Another thing you might want to be saving is coffee grounds, because coffee grounds add to the soil. They add their organic nutrients to the soil, and they also help make it friable, tillable, nice and humus, that's what it is.
Now, does that add an acidic quality to
it? It does add an acidic quality. If you have plants that are sensitive to acid, you may want to, you know, go easy on it. Here in Wisconsin, we've been told that because we have limestone, our soil is so alkaline that any amount of acid we could get into the soil is not going to hurt anything and probably will help it.
Well, it's another form of composting, basically.
It is, right. So. And so you would just take your coffee grounds. You can leave the paper on them because that will just decompose and be more decomposing in the ground. Sprinkle it right on top of the snow, or if you don't have snow, just right on your flower beds, your garden, your vegetable garden beds, and your plants will love it. So that's another thing to be saving right now. In the store, at this point, we have to buy our tomatoes, our strawberries, our blueberries. You're not going to be saving these, you're going to be eating these, but you can save the containers, because the containers will be wonderful for you to put your crops of food in, your strawberries when they come ready, your tomatoes when you want to share them with your friends and neighbors. So wash them off, they can stay out in the garage, they don't need to be pampered at all, and then you'll be ready come harvesting time to share what you have.
Could you use it as a little greenhouse for seeds?
You could, and that you must be reading my mind, because my next thing is you can save your egg cartons if you want to start your seeds in the house earlier. I especially recommend marigolds. Marigolds are really tough. They grow quickly, they grow readily, they're happy to grow, And if you put them in a container like this, then all you need to do is cut these things apart when you're ready. And by that time, they'll be starting to fall apart anyway. And you can plant the whole, this whole thing in the ground. And you want marigolds in your garden because they attract birds and pollinators, and they push away the pests and the bad insects from your garden.
So, well, they don't like the smell, right?
They don't like the smell. And some people say they keep rabbits away. I don't know about that, but they're beautiful and they're very helpful in your garden. So save your egg cartons. And another thing you want to save, at least I have found, is to save your toilet paper tubes. Now, there is a toilet paper company, which will remain nameless by me, that is now eliminating these from their rolls. So if you get interested in doing this, you better start stocking up because others may follow. But I have my family trained now, so they save these. You can save your paper toweling rolls too, and then you have more to cut from. But what are you going to do with them? Well, what I do is I start a little mini greenhouse in them. This is another container from the store. Fried chicken. When we buy fried chicken, it comes in this container.
Popeyes.
Which has
Popeyes.
Little, look, it's got little vents even. So at first you can just leave them the way they are. If it gets too humid in there, you can pull them open. And it's perfect size for taking a toilet paper tube, cutting it in half. Don't have to be real accurate. You know, kind of push it back into shape. Put it in there. And then what you're going to do, what I do, is fill it with potting soil and then put my seeds in there. Then they already have the cover on them, keeps the humidity in, and portable, has no holes in the bottom so it doesn't leak. It's perfect. It works really well. I tried it last year.
That's a good use of recycling
and
materials.
And if you're not... using fried chicken because you don't think that's good, you could also use a salad container. What I found though is that you have to cut your tubes in thirds instead of halves so that they fit, because this is a little bit shorter than the fried chicken ones. Another use for these toilet paper tubes is when you plant your vegetables. I usually only do these around my green peppers, but I've heard other people say they use it around all of their vegetables. You would cut it in half, and then after you've planted your pepper, you would put this around the pepper, put a piece of masking tape there, and it serves as a collar to keep cutworms from chopping off your peppers after you've planted them.
Well, you've used that technique for many years, and it really, really is very successful in protecting your pepper plants.
Yes.
Because when they're young and tender, those cutworms just love to...
They will come and your whole crop will be gone.
Yeah.
It'll be flat, lying down. It's horrible. But the next part of my sharing today is flowers. Flowers that you can grow in your house all winter long. One of the best plants that I've found that grow well for me are African violets. This is a north window. They take their turns blossoming. Right now I've got the purple and the pink. Another variety of it with the darker stems. Little ones that I've started. This is also where I often start my avocado seeds. And I also like to have these fun little solar whirligigs, or whatever you want to call them, going.
Mm-hmm.
Well, there's your two.
Oh, sure. I get the Hawaiian hula dancers.
I should put them up here. Maybe they get more light.
Yeah.
Now that the screen is off. There you go. Hula away. So this is my north window. Another one of my little corners where I have a light shining down. This is a south window, but there's a screen porch, so I really don't get any direct sunlight. But this is where I've put my coleus cuttings from that beautiful coleus plant some of you may have seen in other videos. or outside. Every time they get a little bit too tall, I chop them off and put them into some vermiculite and water and start a new one. That way they don't get too leggy, and then I have many more little coleus I can plant. Also, I brought in a shamrock plant that was outside all summer. And this one that I can't think of the name of right now, but it has beautiful pink and yellow flowers on it. Somebody, I'm sure, will know what it is. Mm-hmm. This one gets a little bit leggy during the winter, but come spring, I'll chop it down a little bit, ease it out, keeping it in the shade for a while, and on it goes. I've had this one for 3 years now, and it came from a friend of mine who had it for many years before that, so it's just perpetual if you can keep it going over the winter. Another secluded little corner, again with the light. Many more African violets. Some are blossoming, some are have just finished blossoming, and I'm sure some will start again when the others have done. This was a plant that we received as a prize one time. Rick won it. When it got done with its blossoming, we just cut it down, and we're going to see if we can get it to regrow. And this little thing, well, I shouldn't say little, this was a avocado seed that I started growing here, and I thought, well, I'll keep it here because it's right next to the light, and maybe I can get it to be bushier. Several times I had to move it away because it kept trying to get into this light. And one day I realized that it got into the light and it burned. And right here there's a little bulge you can see. All the leaves burned off. But I thought, well, I'll just give it a try. Well, here it is. It has leaves again, and they're way up here. It's going to be one tall, spindly avocado. Sometimes it's just fun to have just green things in your house. And if you don't have a whole lot of sunlight, you go for something that doesn't mind if it's not too sunny, and that would be a palm tree. This palm tree, I think, is as old as some of our children. We've had it forever. The base is very skinny, but it keeps creating more and more leaves, and it blossoms. This is a blossom for a palm. And it never used to blossom, and then suddenly it started blossoming a couple years back, and every now and again, there the blossoms will be. I've never had any babies, because obviously we don't have any bees in here to pollinate, but it's a good, healthy plant. We've almost killed it a couple of times because we did put it outside for the summer, and it got too sunny. A couple of tall, spindly avocados. This is what happens to avocados in Wisconsin in the summer. But then you also have the prayer lily and the mother-in-law's tongues and whatever these are. They do not
looks
need...
Looks like an aloe of some sort.
Mm-hmm. They do not need a lot of sun. They will do very well. They don't need a lot of water either. And then somebody that does like to have sun is this rubber tree. It continues to grow even in the lack of sun. I just make sure I water it well. And at one point it was getting too tall, so I chopped it off at a good place. And I thought, well, why don't I just try rooting it and see what happens? So I stuck it the stem into some root hormone, put it into a pot that I kept moist with potting soil, and lo and behold, I have a whole new rubber tree plant right there. It's doing very well. But one of the most exciting of all of our plants is my orchid. A couple of years back, maybe 5 or 6 years back, we were at the end of the winter growing season for orchids at our nursery, our local nursery store, and they were selling out these plants. I think they were $5 or $4 at the time. And they were still in bloom, but they were almost done, and so they were on sale. And I had not been able to get them to bloom since then, because obviously they only get light from the skylights. And about 2 weeks ago, I was watering them and I looked and thought, oh my goodness, this one is so prolific with its rooting. But then suddenly it decided it would bloom and treat us to the blooming. Just fantastic. Now, I hope that's an inspiration to you guys, that this is something you could be doing.
Now, what about the ice cube?
My daughter just bought an orchid at the store, and her directions said, she has a, it's in a pot about this big, to put 3 ice cubes in and once a week, and that's enough water for them for a whole week. Well, we went to the nursery yesterday, and I'm going to show you what we got. Also, these are the tiny little orchids that we bought at the nursery. The woman said, I don't know why people don't buy these, because there's still a lot of growth that will take place and more blossoming, but it just scares people because these obviously are done. And then she started to point out the places that still had blooms. There's one, there's another one, and the tip of this one is going to go. So there's still a lot of growth there and blossoming. And when I looked at the directions on this one, it said, lo and behold, 1 ice cube per week. Our question is, do you put it right on the roots? Isn't that going to freeze them? They obviously just spray them, she said. They just spray them, and I don't know if they water them or what. But this one would be easier because it doesn't have as many roots. There would be a place to actually set the ice cube down inside of it without being on a root. But this one, too, just look at that. Yeah. Look at all those blossoms that are ready. These have not yet opened.
Well, not only that, but, you know, because of the end of the season, they had these at a tremendous discount. I think they were, I want to say, at least 75, 80% off, because I think these were only, what,
$4? These were $4, yes.
And most of these other flowering plants that they had there also only ended up being like $1.
Right.
$1.50.
Now, these were primrose. Now, in this climate, primrose stays green all winter long. If we dug the snow up where our primrose is, the leaves would still be green. And when you buy something that's on sale, because it's the end of the season, you know, you just tidy it up a little bit. You're going to take off the leaves that aren't as attractive, take off the old blossoms, and then come springtime they will slowly be moved outdoors, and I'll plant them right in the ground, and they will come back again, and next spring they'll blossom all over again, but this time it'll be our blossoms. So if I'm looking at this one, here's some kind of an unattractive leaf right here. This is not very attractive. And I'll take this little old spent blossom off. And there's a cheery little face looking at us in the middle of winter. I'll just take this one too while I'm at it. Then there was this one. I don't know that this was on sale. I can't remember if this one was.
All of these were.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they were all $1, $1.50.
These two actually are the same variety, just a different color. Yeah. This one's a little farther gone. This one is just beginning. And I like the way they have them in these tiny little pots now. They have it, they're actually in a plastic pot inside of a pot, so I don't need to try to find a container to put under it. One of the other plants they had on sale, she said that they'd had maybe for 2 years. And when we said, well, what is it? She said, it's a painted aloe. And she said, after looking at the pot, she realized somebody actually had painted it. But it's been like this for 2 years, and it didn't seem to have a harmful effect on the leaves, which I don't know what they used for paint. She didn't either, but it's very pretty, and it's Packer-like, but Packerland. It's just the right colors. This one called to me, even though it's kind of a crinkled up, crinkly
crippled looking croton, because we took a trip to Florida one time and I fell in love with crotons and how beautiful the leaves are. So even if it doesn't have blossoms, just the coloration of the leaves themselves are beautiful.
Well, plus if you cut them back, they'll regrow as well,
yes,
right?
That's so, what I'm going to try.
Yeah.
Yep. And this one too, on sale because it's, you know, it's kind of scraggly looking. I think we paid $3 for this one.
I don't even know if we paid that much, because all of those in that area were either $1 or $1.50.
And that's what you need to do. If you're on a budget but you still want some color in your house, go to the back of the area where they have their sales going on, and you will find plants that there's nothing wrong with them. They've just gone past their prime as far as flowering right at that moment, and they're trying to get new shelf space in the front of the store for all the new things that are coming in.
You do want to check plants though for any infestations.
Oh, definitely.
Just before you bring them in the house.
Yes.
Too. So
you're going to look for mealybugs, which are like white pieces of cotton on your plant, and you're looking for spider mites that look like spider webs, and
yeah,
aphids, which leave a sticky substance on them. So
look
check
under
them
the
over.
Leaves.
Look under them, right? This one needs washing because they've been spraying it with water from the tap, which is, you know, full of minerals. Then we did have to splurge a little bit. We did buy this banana plant. Obviously,
it called to me.
It called to Rick, and it's so tropical looking. It just was lovely, and we couldn't pass it up. It'll do well outside in the summer, and
mm-hmm.
then we'll have to bring it in.
Yep.
Probably we'll never get a banana on it, but we can always pretend it has bananas.
Yes, we have no bananas.
We can see it with bananas in our mind's eye. And then the one big, well, I should say, this was our second big splurge, was bulbs that are being forced. That's another way of going to get flowers in your home at this time of the year, is you can force spring blooming bulbs so that they start blooming in your house beforehand. And all I need to do now is just cut this off. Actually, I think I'm going to cut this whole thing off because I want it to be able to drain. The directions are on the outside of the plastic, which I have already read. So I'm just going to take this off so that it can drain properly. I don't want it to be soggy. This was a little bit more expensive, but this smells so good. There we go. Okay.
Now these look kind of like a miniature hyacinth rather than the hyacinths that I'm familiar with
outside.
Well,
they're not open all the way, so
true.
Give them a chance. They don't smell yet either. These are just, this is spring. When you talk about the smells of spring, lilacs and hyacinths are,
well, I just ordered you three Chinese lilac trees, bushes,
yes,
that never get to be taller than 30 inches, and they bloom all
in the
summer long,
right.
2 to
yes.
3 months
anxious
of blooms.
To see those. And then our one big exotic splurge was this. Now we saw these, and we've seen them before. They're air plants. Now let me get the name of them. She wrote it down for us so we wouldn't forget. Tillandsias. I think that's how you pronounce it.
Yep,
Tillandsias. And that's this part right here. It's an air plant. It has no roots. It gets its nutrients from the air. This looks to me like moss. She said the moss will probably die away because you just can't keep it moist enough. They too said they only spray this one a couple of times a day. The directions say water, 2 ounces of water every 2 weeks.
Well, what I thought was kind of cool about this one is you can hang this in your window.
Yes.
And have different levels of plants growing.
Mm-hmm.
Now, does this need a lot of direct light?
It says display anywhere and water with 2 ounces of water every 2 weeks. So it doesn't seem to be particular about where it grows.
Very oriental in its structure.
Yes. So that was our fun for yesterday. That was our Valentine's treats to each other, is buying flowering plants and going looking in the greenhouse and seeing what was coming up. So yeah. If you have a chance, and if your sweetie pie wants to know what you want for Valentine's Day, take a little trip over to the your garden center and see what's growing, what's on sale, and enjoy color and flowers in the winter. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Thank you very much for watching, and we'd love to hear your comments and answer any questions we can. If you want to become part of our garden family, please subscribe. Love to have you.
Oh yes, I can never get enough plants.
They're everywhere. They're everywhere.
Mm-hmm. Thank goodness for that.
Even in the windows over there.
Yeah.
They're our buffer against snow.
I much prefer that.
Connect with us on YouTube.